Where's Brody?
I don't know. He said he'd meet us here at the food court right about...
Okay, girls, I'm here.
Now.
So, what gift have you decided our class is going to get Mr. Lancaster? What have we decided?
Yeah, this is supposed to be a group decision. The officers of the class were given the task of buying something nice for our teacher together.
Right, but shopping is kind of a girl thing, don't you think?
Oh, please, that's so not PC. You know, politically correct.
Gender profiling.
What? Okay, so we have to find a present for our homeroom teacher. As president of the class, I make a motion that the vice president and treasurer take the collected money and go buy his gift. All in favor?
No way, man.
No, Brody. The class entrusted us with all this money, and they asked us to make the decision.
But I have stuff I need to do.
Exactly what stuff do you need to do?
Well, I'm going to be back down by the apartment store in an hour. My sister's in the Christmas pageant, and the new game system's on display at the Game Depot. I'm so getting that for Christmas. Thought I'd go up and work on my skills.
I don't think so, Brody. Majority rules.
You're helping us shop for Mr. Lancaster.
You just don't have any Christmas spirit.
What are you talking about? I've got the spirit.
No, you don't. See, the Christmas spirit is when you stop thinking about yourself and you start thinking of others.
I think about my mom and dad all the time.
That's sweet.
I think, do they have enough money to give me what I want for Christmas?
That's just sad.
Oh, really? What do you call this?
Just what?
Take a look around. Listen, these people don't look or sound like they have the Christmas spirit either.
Well, when Officer Paul, the mall cop, hears this, he'll make them stop.
Christmas, show someone you care. There will be joy in your heart when you
Put your jump up in a 22 straight. It's all about the giving on Christmas Day. Stop your whining, it's all about love. That's what the season is truly made of. That just happened. Move it, move it along. Nothing to see here. Merry Christmas, shoppers.
I know it's nice to say it's better to give than to receive, but, you know, you have a long Christmas list, too.
What?
What are you trying to say?
See, we all want to get this gift-finding thing over with so we can move on to what we want to do. Let's stop being picky and pick something. Perfect! I've got it! Here's our gift for Mr. Lancaster. Let's wrap it up.
A light and makeup mirror?
No. A 100-watt professional makeup mirror.
I don't believe you.
I'll bet he doesn't already have one. Do you gift wrap?
Forget it. This is a special person, and he deserves a special gift. Would you like a chicken nugget?
Ooh, I love these.
Thanks.
Yeah, thanks. Did I hear you're looking for a special gift for somebody special?
Yeah,
totally. We really need a gift for our homeroom teacher.
I've got it. I know what we can give him.
What?
Who doesn't like chicken nuggets?
You want us to get Mr. Lancaster chicken nuggets?
Yes, chicken nuggets are perfect. Do you gift wrap?
Stop it, Brody.
You just don't ignore him, please.
Well, if you're searching for something really special, I know of a great shop. They have things that you won't find anywhere else.
Really? Do they have video games?
Brody! It's called Tiff's Gifts. Here's a card about the place. It's right up the stairs next to the department store.
Tiff's Gifts, coming for the great Christmas giveaway.
Thanks, we appreciate your help.
No problem.
Tiff's Gifts? Are you kidding me? Sounds like sissy things and doilies. I'd rather have chicken nuggets or a lighted makeup mirror.
Well, let's at least check it out.
Here we go.
Hope you guys find something and remember.
It's better to give than remember now, don't let your heart be deceived. Think of others, kids, and all the people that you see. It's better to give than receive. This Christmas, show someone you care. There will be joy in your heart when you share. Think of others, kids, and all the people that you see.
Merry Christmas! Welcome to Tiff's Gifts.
Cool!
Thanks.
Would you by chance be Tiff?
Oh, yes I would. And you are?
I'm Brody, president of our homeroom.
Well, well. Hail to the chief.
Huh?
Never mind.
And I'm Ashley, the vice president.
And I'm Haley, the treasurer.
Wow! President, vice president, and treasurer. Then I must be Queen Tiff of the Land of Gifts. Nice to meet you.
Thanks. Hey, Tiff, you look really familiar, but I've never been in the store before.
I'm thinking the same thing.
Whatever. Look, we're in a hurry. We need to find something for our homeroom teacher.
Oh, really? What is he like?
I don't know. He's kind of old.
Old?
Yeah, like 30 or something.
He's a geezer.
30. I see your problem. Well, can you tell me anything else about him? What is he like?
He wears cowboy boots.
And I think he has a bowling trophy on his desk.
And I know he reads a lot.
He sounds interesting. Tell me more about the reading part. What does he like to read?
Well, it's mostly the Bible.
The Bible. Okay, that helps a lot. Then I bet your teacher knows about the greatest gift ever given.
The greatest gift?
Mr. Lancaster has talked about that before.
Mr. Lancaster? Really?
Get a present wrapped up in a Christmas bow.
guys, what's up?
Oh, you're so good.
Hey there, Tiff.
Hi, Tiff. Do you have our gift wrap? I sure do. It's right here.
It's beautiful.
Our dad's gonna love it.
It's the perfect present for this year.
Yeah, I think it is.
I wonder what perfect present they bought.
Yeah, me too.
Okay, I'll ask. Hey, Tiff, we'll take whatever present you sold them, and we'll pay it double if we need to.
Well, it's not that kind of gift.
What?
Not all presents are things. Some can't be bought or sold.
What do you mean?
Well, Tiff told us that things can wear out, rust, or break.
She helped us find our dad something that will last a lifetime.
For luxury and hope to satisfy the longing in their heart they can't seem to deny.
Some look for fashion and some for new toys. Anything and everything to bring them joy. Advertisements always promise so much more. The empty life will keep us shopping at the store. I heard the perfect present and people
box.
Well, all year we've been coming by Tiff's door and she's been helping us write thank you notes.
They're notes to our dad. He's had kind of a rough year. He's been in and out of work. We want to tell him how much we loved him.
Yes, and Dylan and Stella, you sure have. And now we've wrapped all these sweet notes up in this beautiful box. Here you go. It's ready to go under the tree.
Oh, I see.
I hope your dad likes his gift. No, I know he'll love it. Merry Christmas, you two.
Thank you, Tiff. Merry Christmas.
Hey, guys. Hope you found the perfect present.
Thanks.
So, we'll give him a note.
And tell him we love him.
But what do we buy him? I vote we go back downstairs and get the lighted makeup mirror.
No, Brody.
Tiff, what's a good gift for a good teacher?
Well, I can tell you about a good gift some people gave to a good king. Maybe that'll help you.
Okay, but can we keep it rolling? I'm on a deadline. I need to get to my sister's Christmas pageant.
Okay, I'll try. A long time ago, some wise men brought three gifts to the king that were so unique. They still puzzle people, even today.
You want us to get him a puzzle?
No, not a puzzle, silly. Maybe these three gifts will help you discover what to get your Mr.
Lancaster!
That's right.
Follow the stars and search for the king. In the prophet mind of control.
Yeah, that's it. My dad says gold's a good investment. How much gold could this money buy?
Brody, what are you thinking?
Yeah, do you want us to buy him gold cufflinks or something?
I don't think Mr. Lancaster wears gold cufflinks. Well, what I mean is, do men even wear cufflinks anymore?
My grandpa does, and he's old.
But with cowboy boots?
I see your point.
So, instead of getting him gold cufflinks, how about giving him a gift from a heart of gold, like the song said?
A heart of gold? Is that like giving from your heart?
I think it means you give your very best.
I think you're both right. And I think that if your teacher were here, well, he'd say to look to the Bible for gifts that were given from a pure heart.
Hey, Tiff, we're back.
Merry Christmas.
Hi, guys. I have your gifts ready.
It's beautiful.
It is.
Tiff's gifts always come wrapped.
We're so glad you opened this store.
Yeah, for the last 2 years, we've gotten all of our presents here.
Oh, I'm so glad to hear that. I hope you enjoy your gifts. Merry Christmas, you two.
Thanks.
Bye. Merry Christmas.
Tiff, you've been here for 2 years? I've never seen this place.
I have. But I never really wanted to come in.
Tiff, what made you decide to open the store? It's kind of different.
Well, I'm glad you asked. Here's how it happened.
Christmas time was approaching. Snow was starting to fall. Shoppers choosing their presents. People filling the mall. Children waiting for Santa with excitement and glee. A little boy tugged my sweater, looked up and asked me, "Where's the light you see, Jesus?
I celebrate Christ's birthday every year. It's all about him.
So, Tiff, what's your profit margin?
Huh?
Well, do you make any money here?
Brody, that is not appropriate. He really does have issues.
No, wait. Before you start dissing me, let me explain. I'm trying to figure out if the whole idea of Tiff's gift is helping us find a gift, or is it her gift to us?
I don't understand.
See, all day, Tiff has been trying to show us how to give like our Lord gave to us. He loved us so much that he gave us his perfect presence, his love. He also gave us his best, his one and only son.
Oh, look, everyone. It's time for the Christmas pageant.
Look, Brody. There's your little sister. She's there holding baby Jesus.
Yes, I see her. She's holding the greatest gift of all, Jesus.
Brody, I think you've got it. And if your teacher were here, I'd say he'd be very pleased with your insights.
Born in a manger, the gift of God's love, the priceless treasure from heaven above. Our God is with us, Emmanuel's near us. A humble manger stall holds the Lord of all.
Away in a manger, no crib for a bed, the little Lord Jesus lay down his sweet head.
Born in a manger, the gift of God's love, the priceless treasure that heaven's above. Our God is with us, Emmanuel's near us, a humble manger still holds a
to her firstborn, a son, and she wrapped him in cloth and placed him in a manger because there is no room for them in the inn.
There were shepherds sitting out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks by night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them.
Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of great joy that will be for all people. Today in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you.
He is Christ the Lord!
Hear me, Lord Jesus, I ask you to stay.
Hi, honey. I delivered those packages after school and I
got
super
early. Mr. Lancaster? What are you doing here?
Hey, hide the money.
Hey, what's going on here?
Well, I figured you guys were talking about my husband.
What? You're married?
Yes, my husband. When you mentioned a really old guy who wears cowboy boots, has a bowling trophy on his desk, and likes to read the Bible.
Hey, who said I was old?
So, Mr. Lancaster, you're married to Tiff?
That's right. 5 years last June. So, what are my class officers doing inside of Tiff's gifts anyways? Looking for a present for someone special?
No.
Well, let's just be honest, guys. Mr. Lancaster, we came here to find a gift for you.
I don't need anything.
But we've got all this money, donations from the class.
Wow, that's nice.
What are we supposed to do with it?
Well, let me tell you what I think your teacher would like. May I?
Of course.
You see the tree over here?
Yeah, the Christmas tree.
Tiff and I call this tree the Great Christmas Giveaway.
You can see it's covered in gift tags. Each tag has a name and a special need listed. There are children who need toys. Oh, this one. It's a single mom who needs babysitting one afternoon a week.
Oh, I want this then.
And this one. It's an old retired man who just needs help shoveling snow.
I can help with that, Tiff. Give it to me.
Hey, I like this idea. The Great Christmas Giveaway.
And guess what? As you give, you get something in return.
Really? What?
You get the joy of giving.
Hey, I wonder if any one of those kids on that tree wants a cool game system.
Well, Brody, I'm sure that
Brody,
would be...
you mean?
Well, I've already got games I haven't even played yet. I'd like to give the new one that's under my tree to someone who really wants it.
Brody, that's great.
It's nothing. As president of the class, gotta set an example, right?
Come on, guys, let's go over by the tree and get started to pick some more gift tags. If that's all right with you, Mr. Lancaster.
It would be a joy.
Hey, Tiff, now I know where I've seen you before. Mr. Lancaster keeps a picture of you up on his desk.
Oh, yeah, that's where I've seen you.
Well, she's much prettier in person. Hey, I'm starved. How about we all get out of here and go get some chicken nuggets? I love those things.
I told you, don't say a word.